Good morning, traders. Welcome to today's market review. This is Fred Razak at CM Trading. Today is December 17, 2018, and today is Monday morning. So looking at the major economic events of the day, nothing scheduled for today, but Wednesday, in 2 days from now, we have a major event, December 19th, Fed rate decision for the FOMC coming out of the United States. That's a major decision, and it's the last of the year. So we're going to take a look at that as that progresses throughout the week. So I expect a little bit, a little lighter volume until then, until we see some clear from some of the smoke that we've been experiencing. Now, looking at the Forex symbols, currency sell-off versus the U.S. dollar last week. However, they are, you know, pointing up higher this morning just on the fact that the Dow Jones is bouncing off of this 24,000 level, okay? But will it hold? That's the major question. And we'll also answer commodities in terms of gold. Basically, it's breaking its 1240 support level, but will it bounce? Okay, that's the real question that we see there. We don't see gold taking off. I would have expected gold to take off, but it hasn't. And we'll see the comparison versus the Dow as the Dow has been breaking apart. Now, lastly, we're going to look at the stocks. Apple hits lower support at 165, and that looks like it's actually going to bounce. So we're going to take a look at that as well. But let's see what we can expect from today's trading. So we're going to start here with the Euro USD just to give us a barometer of what's been going on in the markets. As you can see, over the past, you know, 2 months or so, we've been trading pretty much in a range, okay, as you can see here, mostly because the dollar's getting stronger. The euro, the GBP, just a little uncertainty with what's going on there. And as you can see, altogether, that's where we've been trading, okay? Every time we hit this 1275-ish level, we bounce above it, and we continue rallying somewhere into the 113-ish level, okay? And then we sell off, okay? So at these levels, this is what you should play until we see some sort of breakout, either on the upside or the downside. I'd be more inclined to think it's going to happen on the downside, but you're going to have to really play the trading range to your advantage, okay? If you picked it up here at 1275, this 1311 would put you in a 36 pip cushion, okay? Not to say that that's a home run, but to make 36 pips on a trade, pretty decent trade for a day, okay? So looking at that and considering that the environment is changing a little bit in terms of the GBP USD, we see that we're weaker and we're sitting there on support right there, a 125.70-ish level. It just seems like they're waiting for something to come out to either propel the GBP higher or lower based on what the climate's going to be. Now, looking at the Aussie dollar, breaking lower our support from 71.90. We spoke about this last week. We did expect it to bounce off of it. It didn't, since it didn't make a higher low here, okay, which was a little bit disconcerting with the 72.30-ish level. So it looked like it was more inclined to break this support level at 71.90. Now, your support becomes resistance, okay? They bounced to the 71.86, now selling off to 71.73-ish level. I would expect it to continue correcting itself on the downside, but I don't want to celebrate that too soon just because the volume is still very light. I'd like to see some continued volume here and to see some sort of impetus for us to go up higher. Now, jumping into gold. Gold broke this 1240-ish level last week, and now it's, you know, bouncing off its 1234-ish support, which was the next real support level down here, as you can see, but nothing really writing to, you know, nothing to write home about, basically. We bounced from our low of 1150, 1190-ish level back in, you know, November time, and since then, we haven't really, you know, considered and continued this rally as we've entered this latter part of the year, which seems to imply that the markets are not finished yet, okay? It seems to imply that Dow Jones still has way to go above, okay? The markets are pretty strong in the United States right now. So the only thing that's holding it back is some of the geopolitical issues between Donald Trump and China, what happened with NATO, what happened with the NAFTA between Canada and Mexico. A lot of, you know, new world order, if you will, is happening. A lot of shuffling in the market. So that has yet to dispel on how that's affected the market. So we're going to have to see how that actually works out. Now, looking at the Dow Jones, we bounce off of this 24,000-ish level. Okay, we're trading right now at 24,188. We're looking for some positive information. Now, the last time the Fed came out and said anything, we were right up here. Okay, that was the last time. 26,200-ish level, we bounced to it. Okay, that was actually a point that, you know, we actually considered selling it short. And sure enough, it sold off quite drastically down to the 24,000 level, then bounced back, which was unheard of, and then, did it again. So we're really in a rocky road right now. Okay. If the Fed comes out and says some positive things about the market, we could take off. Okay. The climate is there. It's just a matter of whether or not this geopolitical issues are going to weigh into the market as we continue trading that. Now, lastly, looking at Apple, let's clear off the chart. We're looking at Apple at, say, 165. As you can see, this was a previous resistance level right there. Okay, so we are looking for this to bounce off of this. Now, it's sharply sold off from $230 a share down to 165. That's a lot of money. So it's about $70 a share, more than, almost a third of its, rally since, from its $20, $30 area where it was, just about 5-6 years ago. So, ultimately we're looking for that bounce here. I would be more inclined to think we would bounce here. Okay, so it's not really, picking bottoms right here. So, with that said, just be cautious, okay, because there's still room for this to correct itself on the downside. But ultimately, look at that. I mean, that's a tremendous correction. So from where we've come from, so be aware of it. Just trade responsibly, and trade a little bit lighter, just because until FOMC comes out, it gives us a little bit more direction in the markets. This is Fred Razak. I want to wish you guys a great trading day. Thank you.